astronomers have discovered a set of 8 X-ray rings around a low-mass black hole in B404 Cygni using NASA's Chandra X-ray Observatory and Neil Garrow's Swift Observatory. V404 Cygni is a binary system located about 7,800 light-years away in the constellation of Cygnus. The black hole is actively drawing material away from a companion star into a disk around the invisible object. This material glows in X-rays, so astronomers refer to these systems as X-ray binaries. The X-ray images of the huge rings have revealed new information about dust in our galaxy, using the same principle as X-rays performed in doctors' offices and airports. In this type of binary system, material flows from the star towards the black hole and collects in a disk, where it's heated up and shines brightly at optical, UV, and X-ray wavelengths before spiraling into the black hole. The binary system initially rose to prominence more than 80 years ago, in 1938, during a nova explosion. In 1989, there was an outburst of the binary system, which was discovered by the Japanese X-ray satellite Ginga and high-energy equipment aboard the Mir space station. On June 5, 2015, NASA's Neil Garrow Swift Observatory discovered a flare of X-rays from the binary system. The burst formed the high-energy rings from a phenomenon known as light echoes. The light echoes were created when a burst of X-rays from a black hole system bounced off dust clouds between V404 Cygni and Earth, instead of sound waves bouncing off a canyon wall. Cosmic dust is not like ordinary dust. It resembles smoke and is made up of tiny solid particles. In a new composite image, X-rays from Chandra have been merged with optical data from Hawaii's Pan-STARRS telescope that shows the stars in the field of view. The image contains 8 concentric rings. X-rays from V404 Cygni flares detected in 2015 reflect off distinct dust clouds, creating each ring. The new image provides yet another fascinating view of mysterious black holes and how X-ray observatories can illuminate otherwise invisible aspects of the universe. Astronomer Sebastian Hines and colleagues from the University of Wisconsin-Madison studied 50 swift observations of V404 Cygni made in 2015 between June 30th and August 25th, as well as Chandra observations made between July 11th and 25th, 2015. The event was so bright that Chandra's operator strategically put V404 Cygni between the detectors to prevent the instrument from being damaged by another bright burst. The rings reveal not just the behavior of the black hole, but also the landscape between V404 Cygni and Earth. For instance, the diameter of the rings in X-rays reveals the distance between the intervening dust clouds from which the light ricocheted. The ring appears to be larger if the cloud is closer to Earth, and vice versa. Since the X-ray burst lasted only a few seconds, the light echoes appear as narrow rings rather than large rings or halos. The astronomers also used the rings to investigate the properties of the dust clouds themselves. They compared the X-ray spectra, that is, the brightness of X-rays over a range of wavelengths, to computer simulations of dust with various compositions. Different dust compositions will result in varying amounts of lower energy X-rays being absorbed and prevented from being detected by Chandra. This works in the same way that different parts of our bodies or luggage absorb different quantities of X-rays, providing information about their structure and composition. The team of researchers discovered that the dust is most likely made up of graphite and silicate granules. Furthermore, they found that the densities of the dust clouds changes are not uniform in all directions after investigating the inner rings with Chandra. Previous research had assumed they did not. This result is related to a similar finding made by Sebastian Hines in a study of the X-ray binary Cercinus X1, which contains a neutron star rather than a black hole. If you like this video, please consider subscribing and click the notification bell so you do not miss any upcoming videos.